Hello everyone, this is Henry. I'm going to show you a project I'm working on. It's commissioned by Deanne, an artist. She has already have this seal, as you can see here on the lower left. It was translated from her English name phonetically, I think. Okay, so the last name initial was a K. In Chinese, no matter how long your last name is, we can only use the initial, the only first syllable usually, or for first letter. So for K, sorry, this is a kind of short. Sorry, let's grind some ink here. The Chinese family name comes first, so this pronounced as Gao, or in old spelling, in old books spells K. That's why if your initial is K, you can use this family name. It's Hai. It doesn't mean anything. It's just family name. And okay, this. Character, second character is D, means united. It reads from top down, from right to the left. And then originally this artist who did the name seal try to make a maybe personalized name. So he chose or he created this character with this jade radical on the left, and then for the character N, this is derived from D. Actually, it's spelled as D-I. And this character is on in the original design. And here we simplified it or standardized it as this. So you don't need the. I tried to find this character in dictionary, I couldn't, but in the name it could be a rare character, you know, or anything in the dictionary, but this one is not even found in the dictionary. So I suggested the client to use a common one. This means secure or peace. And this character is often seen in our name seals with the four character, because in Chinese name the most commonly three characters family name, and then the first given name in two characters, and to make it balance, you know, we would add the fourth character, which means the seal. So this character is pronounced E. Many people don't know what's that, and they ask me, what's that character EP mean? This is not EP, okay. This is a Chinese character for seal, but in seal script, the E comes on top, and this P part looks like this. It's actually a place or something in the original meaning, but here it just means a seal or stamp or chop, if you like. We call it seal more formal, because once you have this seal, it's official. It looks official. For small seal, you might want to separate the first name from last name. So I usually have two seals like this size. One with just the family name, and one with the two characters for its given name. And forget about this fourth character. If your name is not so complicated like this one, we can squeeze in four characters, but in many cases we cannot, so we have to do it separately. Understand? Anyway, so this is what we were trying to finish carving based on the design. So the first thing I'm going to do is to transfer the design. I made the design on my computer with the Photoshop. So we need to transfer it. I'll show you in a moment. I need to erase the polish or the wax that comes with the stone first. Just use sandpaper. Remove the polish. And then I rub the design on this. Okay, and use a liquid called acetone. It's a polish, nail polish. Oops, I think we move the mark a little bit. You can see what's going on here. Acetone remover is what it's called. It will remove the paint and put on, transfer the paint, the ink, onto the stone. Just like that. The best part of this is it's waterproof once it's dry. It dries quickly, within seconds, so it's ready. I'm going to put it on the clamp. It's so small, I need to make a pad. Otherwise, I cannot use this. Oops, it's upside down. Okay. Size of a stone, I better do it with the engraving or the in style, negative carving style. Just cut out the strokes. Okay, I'm going to work on this character first, whichever comes into my mind. I think it's interesting to start. If you can hear the sun. Okay. Subtle pressing and lifting created the calligraphy strokes. This is a roof on top, and then a lady under the roof sitting. That means a secure or peace. It's a pictograph. In name, you know, just a representation of the sun and an. That's the second syllable syllable of Deanne. Oops, I got to slipper, but that's okay. I mean, adjust the design basically. And this happens. So that's why I make a recording of what happens. Let me show you the process. The design is just the plan, and you need to have plan B. When something happened. And you cannot really see what happens. Just merge, touch the two strokes together to create a more kind of interesting space. This is only 3/8 of an inch, or 1 centimeter. The smallest this seal will do. Actually, there are some artists who they don't take any seal under 1.5. It's considered miniature. I think I'll make it a rule that you can only carve 2 or 1 character. So for 3 character name, you have to do 2 seals. Separate the first and the last. Okay, let me show you the design I have. Just do stuff. You cannot really see this on the actual stone. Okay, for small seals, you cannot really go deeper because the strokes are so narrow. Let's see, Hawks, this paper. Okay, because the seal is made of stone, we need to put a rubber pad in it. I put a mirror, it just to make the surface firm, and you can just put directly on the table if you would, because I got a soft pad here, so I use another piece of hard surface, you know, flat surface to support it. And here's the design. I used old relatively dry ink to start with. This give me a close, very kind of dry copy. I need to see the strokes. Just take the remaining ink with a soft tissue. If it's dry, it will stuff the strokes, and then you can use toothbrush to remove it with a gentle detergent or dishwasher or whatever to remove, because it's oil based. You need to use a little soap. Soap will help. Okay, so it's basically done, I think. Just check a few things. Just to fix a little bit. There is a stroke there, I think. I'm not sure, so let me just make it a little clearer. Oops. Actually, you know what? Small knife may not help, because it's not as stable. The fresher ink. It should last forever, you know, like a lifelong. This one has been more than a decade. Sure. Okay. Delicate, so just a little bit pixel level adjustment. Let me mark the left with signature. So here. The converse, the signature is usually located on the left side. Help you identify the orientation. That's my signature. I kind of like the some lost and found kind of feel, because it's such a small seal, you don't really want to have everything so perfect, you know, completely clear. So there's no rhythm. Each print is different. You know, if you press less, the stroke will be a little bit wider or broader. So this side in the, on the left. Oops, I missed the padding under it. And here, you know, I have a tool called the square ruler, and you help me to kind of match the print if I have to do it twice. It's a transparent ruler, square ruler, and you can get, if you missed, if you have to make up, or if you want to align perfectly, you can use that kind of tool. L-shaped ruler. put a link in the description. Sometimes confusing with two delights because there is no shadow to see. So make sure you use very soft tissue because these strokes are pretty shallow. If you use a paper towel, you may erase it soon. And better just wash it with water and then a soft toothbrush. Okay, I call it finished. Yeah, you can see the design on the computer is pretty whitish. If I do this much white stroke, the red would be too. too pale, you know, on the paper. So I think I just leave this. Because of the challenge of a small scale with four characters is really hard to do. So I'll make an exception. No more than two characters next time. If you want, you can just use the last name on the seal. It would be very nice. Oops, I missed it. I forgot to check the orientation. So your signature could be, if you sign in Chinese, I would do the given name and then with the family name on the seal. They complement each other. Okay, I'm going to make an official imprint on the this album. Here the recent seals have done. Directly done. No waving needed, actually. You can wave a little bit if you want to make sure it's R even. Okay. Let's try on a piece of computer paper or card. Different paper may look different. Blow a little bit moisture from moss to help reduce the grain. But if you press harder, the line will be finer. If you press less, the line will be thicker, slightly. Some lost and found strokes are nice to my eyes, so I don't mind. That each time it will be different which one is, you know, if you compare this character, see. So they're all good. Zoom, I mean, the focus a little bit. That's it for this project, and thank everybody for watching. Thank Deanne for your patience and commitment to my artistry, trust to my artistry. Thank you, bye bye now.